So the, you know, for everyone who's joined in time, we'll just begin. So good afternoon. Welcome to everyone for, this wonderful session. We are going to see some very insightful perspective from a very, very fundraising perspective today. And while a lot of us are working on some fantastic technology solutions, most of us keep having issues in terms of raising funds or looking for sources where, you know, we want to raise funds. I keep speaking to a lot of our industry friends, someone who's building, you know, a flight controller, or someone who's building a very large drone, or, you know, something with a very skewed specifics. I believe a foreign collaboration with a very robust partner and a unique source of funding is something that we are looking at today, and for which we have Mr. Rahul Kulshrestha today. Rahul is representing GITA, which is the Global Innovation Technology Alliance. And Rahul, I would want to invite you and, you know, brief and give an overview about you, GITA, and then the topic for the day. We'll be having approximately more than 50 people joining in, but safe to start right away. Rahul?
Okay. Thank you, Smith, for first of all, for arranging this awareness session with Drone Federation of India. And also, it was a very good coordination with you, your team, who has helped me to interact with the people who are working in this area. So first of all, over that, I know it's a very tough time going on, and I hope all of you and your family members, they are safe. And I wish that most of the people are actually coming out of this crisis safely without going into a deep crisis. I would request if all the people can mute their mic.
Rahul, I think you'll have to unmute. I just muted all, so.
Okay. So thank you, Smith. I request all the people to mute their mic, and there will be a question and answer session in the end. So any questions, queries related to the presentation, you can ask me once the presentation is over. So coming to the point, there are a lot of futuristic area where the India is looking forward in terms of development. And one of the area is definitely drone. And after this crisis, especially what we have seen throughout the world, now we are looking towards this flying robots as one of the challenging solutions. So the market, which we was envisaging that it is going to be more than $1,800 million by 2026, we feel that it will get more increase, and it has a more demand in terms of commercial aspects, and most of the focus of the government is now towards this kind of technology. So today I will be giving you a brief about what is GITA, because what kind of mechanism it is, and how you can avail the opportunity of funding with GITA. I will also give you some of the showcase studies, though I cannot reveal much details about the project right now, but I can give you some of the details about the brief about the projects which are going which are funded by GITA in the drones and UAV area. So coming to the point, we are seeing a lot of changes happening after 2018, once the government of India, especially DGCA, has relaxed many of the norms which are required for drones and UAV testing and flying. And still it is going on, and still we are also seeing for a policy which may be coming out for the entry drone detection systems also. So demands are coming from all the sectors, starting from the surveillance, agriculture, if you talk about the medicine delivery, and also in terms of a disaster management. These are the very futuristic area where we are looking forward, where the drones can be one of the solution to find out and to find out this crisis to go ahead. So I will just share my screen with you all and start with the presentation. I hope it is visible.
Yes, Rahul, we can see it.
Yeah, thank you. So GITA, Global Innovation and Technology Alliance, it's basically a PPP, public-private profit partnership, not-for-profit company, which is promoted basically by Technology Development Board, which comes under Department of Science and Technology, Government of India, and CII. Yes?
Yeah, do you want to go full screen on the presentation?
I have already made a full screen. It's not visible?
No, it's looking at the PPT mode right now.
Okay, let me just reshare it again.
Yeah, perfect.
Sure. So this is a PPP model, which is a joint venture of Government of India, which brings a parent ministry from Department of Science and Technology, with the industrial model of which is a joint venture with the Confederation of Indian Industry. So what was the genesis? Why GITA was originated? What was the thought process? So what we understand that in 2006, there was a delegation which went to Israel along with our S&T minister. And we always, we have collaborations, especially for research and R&D with more than 100 and 120 countries. So we wanted to enhance those kind of collaborations with Israel. So that time Israeli said, yes, we will do R&D collaborations with academia, but we wanted to propose R&D collaborations with industry. So we were not having any mechanism that time which can actually directly fund industry for industrial R&D. So a lot of funds can be given to academia with a lot of directly through DST with multiple programs with different different countries. However, there was very few mechanism which was available that time where the direct government money can actually go to the private industry. We came back from there and we had a thought process how we can do this collaboration. And that time we thought, okay, there is a need where India need to enhance their involvement in industrial R&D and R&D by the private parties. Right now, our contribution to GDP is only 0.5% in comparison to Israel, which is 6%, Sweden, this are the innovation country. So comparative to such kind of countries, our contribution to R&D was very less. So government want a model where the private industry should actually invest in R&D. So what were the challenges generally all the industry face, like even the drone industry, if you see, from 2017 to 2019 onwards, only all tech startups of drones, they have received only 2.26% of funding in terms of compared to the overall deep tech funding which has come to India. So there was no funding available. So industry want to do R&D, but there is a risk of failure. So somebody they need who can actually share this risk. Secondly, a technical know-how. So many of the area, definitely I feel the drone is an area where we have an inbuilt capability and we can develop different kind of drones. But there are many areas where we really do not have those kind of capability. And we need technology and technological collaboration from the international platform where the technical know-how can come to India. It can help us to develop our competencies, skills, help us to develop our infrastructures and capability, and finally, it will develop R&D capabilities in Indian industry. So with this demand and with this requirement, we came out with this a special purpose vehicle, and we started initially with Israel and then Canada, that time with Ontario, one of the provinces in Canada. And then we had seen whether what is the response of industry. And we had seen a very good response. And after seeing such kind of response with the bilateral collaboration and risk sharing of funding, the Prime Minister Council on Trade and Industry, they recommended incorporation of a government arm length entity under TPP mode to professionally manage government fund for flexibly providing to industry for doing R&D, including with global partners. So that was the genesis origin of GITA. So you can see that on 11th May 2012, on National Technology Day, in the presence of our Dr. Abdul Kalam, former President of India, we started GITA. So this is just a background. It is a not-for-profit company with a mandate to encourage industrial R&D, sharing risk in R&D with the industry, Indian industry, I should say. And it is jointly promoted by the Technology Development Board, which is also a part of Department of Science and Technology, Government of India, and Confederation of Indian Industry. So the in order to provide the flexibility, because government need to go for a different kind of tendering process, different kind of timelines. So in order to have a professional mechanism, they have given a majority stake to industry, which is CII, 51%, and government has taken 49%. So that it can be run in the professional way. It should not get stuck due to the timelines of what Indian government generally, sometimes it get delayed because we are running with the international government also. So in order to bring that flexibility, that GITA has been made. So what we are doing right now is we are helping in mapping technologies gap in different area. We evaluate technologies available across the globes, helping the techno-strategic collaboration partnerships, which is very useful for a national importance, social importance, maybe affordable solutions for the Indian economy. This is the board. So we have been guided by an elite board. Many people has been changed, recently nominated. It was started with, right now, our chairman recently he has taken over from Mr. Vikram Kirloskar, who is the vice chairman of Toyota Kirloskar Motor. Mr. Deep Kapuria is our chairman. Similarly, we have government director, Dr. Neeraj Sharma, who is the secretary TDB from the government side. So you can see it's a perfect combination of board of industry who are the champions in their area. We were also guided by the Krish Gopala Krishnans, who is the co-founder of Infosys, Navroj Godrej from Godrej Group. So most of the good groups, they had come forward. They said, okay, we will take part in this such kind of initiative. And the respective funding is also coming from the government of India. This is our vision. What I said, it is to strengthen India innovation ecosystem through supporting and enabling technologies and innovation-driven enterprises. So mission, we wanted to catalyze India recognition as a key innovator, definitely in the global level, inspiring Indian industrial community to recognize R&D. So though in India, we can see the focus toward R&D is keep on growing. We can understand after agriculture, we generally jump to a service sector instead of going to a R&D and manufacturing sector. So that is one area we have to focus. And now most of the government policies, government structures are pushing industry towards doing R&D and developing their own inbuilt capability in terms of research and development. We basically support in enhancing risk appetite of Indian industry for taking up innovative projects. We create a vibrant skilled workforce with the technology collaborations at an international level, and become an enabler for transfer of world-class technology. So many of our program which we have done in the past, it has also helped us in terms of transferring technologies. These are our mandate. So main mandate is funding. We had provided in the form of grant, conditional grant. Also in the past, we had given soft loans also. Right now, we do not give soft loans. All programs has been converted into grant and conditional grants. In terms of R&D innovations, acquisitions, and with the international S&T collaboration. So it's a very unique body in India, which actually provide funding along with the international collaborations. There is no body as such. We have a national body which provide only at the national level, but not at the international collaboration level. Capacity building, strengthening ecosystem, deployment of various schemes of state governments and also the central governments. These are our mandates. So presently, this is our program portfolio, you can see. And major focus is on bilateral program, because I don't want to discuss other programs, because many of the programs are under revival mode under different ministry. But the major portfolio and the mandate has started with the bilateral program. Means we have programs with Canada, Finland, Israel, Italy, Republic of Korea, Spain, Sweden, UK, and the funding is coming from multiple ministries, primarily though it is a mandate of Department of Science and Technology, but there are few countries where Ministry of Commerce, like they are coming on board with Republic of Korea, Electronics Ministry with some countries. So these are the bilateral program. Apart from that, we had done many of the national programs. Technology Development Fund under DRDO, it has been started, floated by GITA only in 2016-17. We only designed the program. I hope you people might be aware right now. A lot of opportunity are there. There was a call where means even I was involved in the feasibility study, which was required for a drone. So under this DRDO funds, I'm just giving you a background so that you can also see this. It is available. All requirements are floated online. So under this Technology Development Fund, the requirements which are coming from Army, Navy, and Air Force, it floated in this. We do a feasibility studies of this requirement along with the industry. So it is a very good platform where the user and the developer and the R&D people like the DRDO labs will together develop this technology which are required by the three services, and majorly focusing on the indigenization purpose. So I still remember that we had done a feasibility study for a drone which are required by the army at the level of Himalaya in such a wild, or I should say a climatic situation and different payload. So many of the industry had taken part from the drone area. They have given their suggestions how these problems can be resolved, how, what kind of drone is required, what should be the payload, endurance, how it can be more compact. So this is how under this technology development fund, initially we do a feasibility studies with industry. We call all the industry. We do our technology workshop. We come out with some specification and finalize the specification of that product, if really Indian industry. After that, DRDO give them a funding up to 10 crores, which is 90% of fund is given by them for the development purpose. And during that time, the customers, even the DGCAs and Semilec kind of agency, which DGQA, which are the qualifying agencies for the defense-related thing, they also take part. So it's a very important collaborative platform. Till last year, we were handling this program. Now, DRDO, they have their own PDF directorate, and only the branding and promotion is done by Invest India. So you can also see a lot of opportunity coming under this. There was a program under heavy industry, which was mainly for the acquisition of technologies, especially for the capital and goods sectors. There was a program which was called as Technology Acquisition Development Fund program under MSME and DIPP. And it was also basically a green technology related fund. Right now it has gone for renewal, and it has been merged with the CLCSS scheme and technology upgradation scheme of MSME. Scientist exchange program, it is for academia, and we had a partnership at the EU level with, we had actually you know, Indigo program in the past, EEN program. So it is a multiple consortium program at the EU level. So majorly the focus is on bilateral program. Sector of engagement, definitely all the sectors we covered. So except defense, I would say, especially for bilateral countries where we do not allow international partners into our defense technology, but any applications coming into the civilian requirement or strategic or the even the space requirement can be considered under GITA. So with each country, we float some priority sectors, but it is not limited to these sectors only. We are looking for a novel solution. We are looking for a solution which is not available into the market right now, and maybe a solution which is much affordable than the solution which is presented into the market, or maybe a solution which is helping us in terms of import substitution, because right now India is one of the importers also for the drone. So definitely in the past, most of our drones, they used to come out from the China, and drone related components also. Though now we are focusing on Indian capability for drone, but still our import, what we are projecting will be 20% of import in the drone area by 2026. So anything which can help us in import substitution, indigenizations of the technology can be considered as a most important factors while funding such kind of programs, because it's government money. The first drone, what I remember, the India has used in the Kargil war, it has come from Israel. And after that, we had our military has started taking more and more drones, and then now we are converting into a civilian sector. So many of the I think some of the company must be available here who are working for the different kind of technologies, like Skylux has worked for the Tata Steel, and there is a recently Zomato has done a deal with Tech Eagle, a company for the drone related delivery. So the market is very, very wide. We cannot imagine the kind of proposals we get in the drone area. Sometimes we also get surprised, oh, this is also possible with the drone. This is the area we fund. So many people, they ask, what kind of funding do you provide? So we do not provide funding for a basic research, which is generally done by academia or a technical, just to prove a technology. So that is not our aim. It's GITA funding basically is looking to fund from TRL level 4 onwards, so where the proof of concept is already available, and we wanted to develop a prototype, and prototype which is a working functional prototype which is ready to go to the market. So this is the area which is called also a valley of death for startups also, because many people, they have an idea, but there is a risk in terms of development. No banks, no investors, most of the times, they do not want to share this risk. And this is the area where the risk funding is available at the GITA platform. So we do not fund for the commercialization. I should tell you, there is a body already, which is our parent body, Technology Development Board, which comes under DST. They fund for commercialization. So DST, if you see, there is a body which has divided all the TRL level. So TRL 1, 2, 3, they do by themselves with the academia, because most of the basic research are done in academia level. And when it has to go to the pilot level, there should be an industry who should come forward. So there it is starting from the TRL level 4 to TRL 7, which is mostly funded by GITA. And after that, once the product is ready for the commercialization, there will be 8 and 9, which will be supported by Technology Development Board. So that is, we are covering from DST point of view, all the TRL level in India. This is the typical structure for bilateral program. So what is happening? The industry from India is coming in collaboration with the industry from the counterpart countries. Whatever will be the total cost of the project, which is, for example, a total cost of the project proposed by both the industries, 6 crores. Out of the 6 crores, it is divided on the Indian side as 3 crores and divided on the maybe like Israeli side on 3 crores. So out of that 3 crores, 50% will be funded by the GITA and DST. So 1.5 crores. So here there is a requirement. So 50% has to come from industry. 50% has to come from government. Similarly, on the counterpart side, like Israeli industry will get 50% from the Israeli government and they will put 50%. So the total amount of risk on individual is only 25%. So this is called a risk sharing model. A technology is getting developed with only sharing 25% risk of funding, and you are getting a collaboration at the international level, and the government is sharing this risk. These are the programs which are rightly, I have put some dates also, many of the calls are going to over very soon. I should say Israel is going on. It has written 3rd, but recently we have extended till 31st of May, Israel call. We are giving maximum funding up to 8 crores on Indian side, you can see, and 50%. So for example, on Indian side cost is 16 crores. We can fund up to 8 crores. It's a matchmaking funding kind of thing. So Spain, in next 7 days, most of the calls have been revised. So Spain has been launched recently, and it is going to end in July. So if you are interested in technology collaboration with Spain, there is an opportunity of 1.5 crores of funding, 50% costing. Similarly for Canada, we have not launched till now. It is going, most probably going to launch in July or August. We are trying to launch it. UK right now, it has gone to a revival mode, so I would not speak about it. Korea is going on right now. So we have very good sectors in Korea, which is future manufacturing, future utilities, healthcare is always there, and then the digital transformation or ICT. So these are the 4 sectors under Korea. And we had already funded one of the project under Korea related to the drone. So I will give you some of the example in the end. Italy, we have not launched. We may be launching in this year. Finland also revival mode. Sweden, this is still going on. We have extended Sweden, but the common means there are 2 calls with Sweden we have launched, I should tell you. So one is focusing on smart grid only. So it is related to the smart grid. No other sector area they want. It is with the Swedish Energy Agency. And the another one is including everything, means smart transports, mobility, urban planning, smart cities, clean tech. So all technological solution can be considered. So that is going to end on 20th of May. In this month only. And another smart grid is going, we have extended yesterday only, so it is up to 10th of June. So you can see all this timeline, sector area, details of this program on our website. It is, everything is given there. Funding is also given, all details, eligibility criteria I'm going to discuss. These are our global strategic partners in terms of from different countries. Canada, we have an RC, IRAP is there, Business Finland, Israel Innovation Authority, and from Korea, we have 3 agencies, CDTI Spain. So these are all the innovation agencies, government innovation agencies in these countries. Vinova Sweden, Innovate UK. So we work with them, they are our counterparts. And what is the GITA role? Means we actually, it is an end-to-end solution. So we start with the government level, basically whenever any prime minister of the country is visiting to any country, or if somebody is coming from any country and we see there is a potential in those countries in terms of R&D collaborations, there are funding available. So we generally project such kind of proposals in those discussions. Once it is approved, like the Israel call has been promoted by both the prime ministers. It has been launched by our prime minister when our prime minister visited Israel, and when their prime minister came to our country, we launched the call actually. So that is how it works. So it is the commitment coming at the G2G level. And then after that, we formulate the programs, we discuss with our innovation agencies, counterpart innovation agency, we do promotions, awareness session, what I am doing right now with you all, partnership development activities. We do a lot of B2B sessions. We help you to finding partners also with the international countries. GITA also do the evaluations with the pool of experts. We have experts from multiple areas, means more than 500 to 600 experts from academia and industries both, and they help us from technical, financial, legal, all background. The evaluations happen for such kind of proposals, and then the funding and also reviewing of this project. So it is a 2 years, maximum 2 years funding or the duration program, where generally what happened, we always Hello.
Rahul, you disconnected for a bit, like the minute.
Sorry. Maybe there was some issue on my side.
No problem. Huh.
Sorry, slide is visible to you, or I have to reach?
No, it was, but now it's not.
Just
no problem. Now it's visible.
Yeah, thank you. So I was talking about the GITA role in terms of project management. It is end-to-end solution, starting from you also find out the countries with whom we should collaborate. We do studies in terms of we have already launched strength of different countries in R&D sectors where we do collaborations. We promote, we see the technology gaps in terms of what are the areas we should actually start funding, which are the futuristic technologies going on. We keep on adding those sector areas in our call based on the changes into the technology markets. So that is what our role. I was saying that this project is always, it is monitored and mentored. So there will be a project mentoring and monitoring committee who will be reviewing this project, who will be directing this project, advising this project people throughout the duration of this tenure. So it is a very good mechanism where you have experts from those fields who help you to understand if you get stuck up during this project, they can direct you in the direction where they can connect you the linkage where it is required. So those are the kind of people who works on our experts committee and helps industry to actually come out with a success, and especially a commercial success. For us, a success is how we determine success is the product is going to the market, it's getting commercialized. A project completion is not a success. It means somebody has given technical deliverable, they have completed but not able to commercialize. It's not a success for us. So we want a product or the technology should go to the market. These are the timelines. We generally launch every call with 4 to 5 months opening. And during this call opening, we do a lot of promotions with different industrial associations. We do B2B meetings. matchmaking exercises, we handhold applicants to make them understand what they can do, what they, based on our experience, we understand what is their requirement. And then after that, once the RFP is closed, 3 months of evaluation times, 1 to 2 months of due diligence. Right now, we are reducing this time also because everything has become online. Earlier, we used to go physically and visit industries. So after this COVID crisis, everything is becoming online. So I'm 24 months of project duration, means development period, I should say. So mostly of 36 months from the starting of launch of call. This is very important slide in terms of who are eligible to get, because this funding is mainly for Indian companies. The companies who are registered under Company Act, okay, either it may be startups, it may be MSME, it may be a large company, and having 51 stake of the company on by the Indian citizens. Headquartered in India, Indian citizens. So in other sense, we are not supporting MNCs. We are supporting companies which are Indian and we, which has 51% shareholding of the companies with the Indian citizens. Definitely, we are looking for a for-profit companies, not NGO, trust. That is what we are not funding. They should have the expertise. So mostly the funding, it's not like a venture capital or means investors who also see the returns. Definitely returns are there, but it's a technical expertise of the team, because it's a government funding. We focus more on the expertise of the team in terms of technology. Sole proprietorship, partnership, even LLP, they are not eligible. We do not fund all this kind of structures of company. And also company which are headquartered and outside India is also not eligible. So these are, we have given all this eligible guidelines detail in our website. These are very important in terms of understanding whether you are eligible for such kind of funding. In glance, we started mainly working in 2011. It took a lot of time for us in terms of, first of all, working with the international government, our government, come out with the funding commitment from both the government and starting and launching calls. So somebody else has started sharing.
Just a second, let me just off. Yeah, I think it's back to you.
Okay, I'm just resharing there.
Yeah.
So most probably after 2015-16 onwards, most of the project and programs actually got launched in a full-fledged way. 100 bilateral project has been approved. It's ongoing right now. We are managing more than 975 crores of government funds for different programs. And national projects also, though major focus is on bilateral, but still, as we have a good connect with industry, understanding on technology acquisitions, we had funded some of the national projects also, which are 27 in numbers. Till now, we have closed 28 numbers of projects also. So country partners, I already said we have 8 countries partners right now. This is the investment what we have attracted for the industry. So that is the main focus, that how we can attract investment from the industry also by sharing risk. So that is 300 crores. Right now, the projects are running in 14 states. More than 52 calls have been launched. So this is GITA in terms of what is going on. Last 4-5 years only, everything has come out properly. Initial time has gone for a lot of discussion, collaborations, commitment at the government level, and finally it has come out. So these are some of the case studies. I can't go much in details, but you can see this project has been funded under India-Korea program. recently 2019, Indian industry is Tata Advance, and there is a Kewa drone company in Korea. They have collaborated and they are developing, because they're looking for a utilization in the ship deck operation. So generally, when we talk about a naval ships or even in the oil and gas sector, mostly they use fixed wing kind of UAV, because in terms of endurance also, and in terms of robustness, because the environment is very difficult there to run, a stability point of view. And but this kind of fixed wing UAV, running from a small deck where the space is very less, the angle of attack requirement is a challenge for even for the Navy purposes and oil and gas industry. So this is a challenge where this two company, they said, okay, we will be going for a morphing wing of concept for the ship deck operations. We have given a funding under India and Korea program. The project is still going on. And so the another project is under Spain. We have seen there is the two company. One is UKIL Fuel. Though it is a automobile company, but many of the companies seeing the opportunity in drone area, they are converting themselves in this area as a diversification. So this is a, they are basically making a hybrid of vertical takeoff, which we generally say VTOL and the fixed wing airplane capability. And for the society, it's not very specific, but they wanted to basically help for the agriculture sector. So the application what they have taken is for the agriculture sector. They have been funded under India Spain. This is also one of the critical project. I should tell, we are facing a lot of technical difficulty in this project, and timelines has been over, but still, if we are looking for outcome, because the outcome is, if we really come out with this kind of solution, it itself is a is one of the achievement for us. So we are just waiting. We are helping team to develop, though they have gone ahead of the timeline. So it's a firefighting application, drone hoppers, which where the industry from Spain is drone hopper. There is a small company in Bangalore, Castcraft. They have a partner also, it is not written, which is expertized in jet engine. And that is what the USP and the innovation coming here is. So the POES jet, they are trying to bring and reduce the size of a jet engine, which generally right now, which we are using in the aircraft, to a size which can be used for this drone hopper. So integration of this jet engine into this drone hopper with the structure and the payload and this everything has is coming from the drone hopper side, Spain. However, the special design, this jet engine is coming from the Indian side, and still we are facing to develop that small compact jet engine, though they have done one stage, but still a lot of challenges there in terms of integration. So we are just waiting, because itself a small compact jet engine developed in India itself is an innovation for us. So we are just waiting. The company, the people who are engaged, they're very experienced, mostly from the ex-HAL, or have a very good experience in terms of jet engine, and they're predicting that they need time, but yes, they can come out with the solution. So we are just waiting for this project to come out. Recently, just few days back, maybe yesterday only, we declared a result. If you have seen our social media website, this is in the recent call. It's basically on the drone detection and neutralization system. So two companies under India Israel, Indian company, is basically they are expertise. So that is what I just wanted to tell you. We are looking for a complementary strength of Indian industry and the counterpart industry here. Actually, we are not looking for a collaboration which is just bringing technical or there is a technology available in some country and I'm just bringing in India, reporting and commercializing. So that's not a purpose of this program. It's a co-development where both the companies should have a strength, complementary strength. So the Indian company, they have expertise in jammers. And the air fins, which comes from Apollo field group, they're having expertise in RF analysis sensors. So combining both, they are coming with the solution of high-end tactical integrated drone detection and neutralization system. It is based on the RF technology. So this is where the two different strength of a company coming together and coming out with a new solution. If you people are aware, under this, there is one program called as IDEX program, which is especially for the startups also under the Ministry of Defense. There also they have raised a request for such kind of drone detection, because now this will be a challenge in future. There are a few challenges in drone area development. One is this, where there will be a need of air traffic management. As per my understanding right now, the limit which has been given by DGCA is 200 feet. And if you see the many of the application, if you talk about recently, we got a very good application in power distribution sector, where a single drone having eight different kind of design parameters which can handle for a power distribution line. It can clean the insulations which are here. It can take the photographs. It can use the artificial. So coming out with this, there was one drone, and then now the artificial intelligence which is coming out. So now many people are started using artificial intelligence even in drone detection. Though many of the technologies are doing with RF sensors based, but many people they started doing based on the image analysis of artificial intelligence. So many technologies are coming. There are numerous number of solutions. I've seen some company coming out for parking solutions. So there are many technologies, and you can get an edge in such technology if you really get something good as a collaborative partner from your technical or from your international partners. So that is where, because everybody looks for a market in India, means all countries are looking for a market in India. It is going to grow, and the drone market is the future. So in that case, we do not want to give them only market. So that is not good. Means they can take a market, they can come and invest. So that is a different route. But here we are saying sharing also. So share technical know-hows with each other, have a joint development, and then join maybe with joint ventures or with the sharing of profit, you can go ahead to the Indian market. That is one way we are actually, many industries are coming forward to such kind of programs. We have a platform, GITA Innovation Exchange platform. We help in matchmaking, technology transfer, joint ventures. So you can actually register to this platform on our website also. And any kind of search you are looking for, most of the people come to us for a search of a partner only. So any kind of search if you're looking for, you can actually register there what you are looking for or you are giving for also. Givers and takers both are means we are calling at this platform, and they can come and look forward for any opportunities, because GITA is a network of many people, whether it is international government, Indian governments, academia, experts, financials, networks, venture capitals, and all. So you can take these opportunities also, coming and checking whether you need something, and you can get it from this platform also. So this is what the presentation from my side. You can visit this our website, www.gita.org.in. You can see some programs are going on, and now it is open for interaction and also Q&A session. Thank you.
Thanks, Rahul. That was very insightful. Just for you know, your background as well, I think we have some very fantastic people on the call as well who will be able to you know, probably match or even outmatch the current projects that are there in the pipeline which has been approved. So request to everyone, if you have any specific questions, you know, please unmute yourself and do ask the question. We'll have one of the questions. I'll be happy to share probably Rahul's email address, and then you can reach out to him separately as well. Any questions?
Yeah, Dr. Sikendra Babu, I have a question. Under this GITA, is it mandatory that we, you know, go for only collaborative programs with other countries?
Yes, yes. It is mandatory for under our bilateral program, because right now we have only bilateral program which are going on. So it is mandatory to have collaborations and collaborative partners from this country.
Okay, now my second question was, in your future upcoming programs, is there anything related to power amplifiers between Korea and India? Is there any discussion has happened, anything related to that?
No, so I said, especially for Korea, we have divided four sectors. One is future manufacturing, utilities, future utilities, and also digital transformations and healthcare. We do not want to go very specific for like power amplifier in that. So any applications coming out which is novel in nature, we accept it. I said, we are not binding you in terms of what we want. We are saying, you come out with some novel thing which is not presently available into the market, you come out with a solution which India is looking for, and we will fund you. So that is what this is.
Okay. Noted. Thank you.
Rahul, I have a small question. While we are talking about collaboration with foreign countries, what about certain technology enablers that are available in India only? Will GITA facilitate that also?
No, at this platform, no. Means, in order to get a funding, you should have a collaborative partners. And you can come out with a consortium also. Huh? It's not like one industry also. It can be industry consortium. It can be industry academia consortium. For academia, if it is coming along with you, academia can get 100% grant under this program. Industry is getting 50% only. Academia can get 100% grant if they are contributing. So it's, you can come out with those consortium and apply with this. But from India to India level, yes, we are not supporting. Like, so because it is already available in India, so there is no need.
Thank you. Thank you.
Hello, Rahulji.
Hello, Rahul.
For the great presentation. I'm interested in knowing which other countries beside Israel are interested in the drone-related collaborations.
So I said, whatever countries, see, that is what I said. It is not only Israel. It depends on the applications also right now, because drone using in agriculture comes under the agriculture area. Drone used for the power distribution may come under the energy area. Okay, drone used for the ship deck operations comes under maybe future manufacturing type of area. So it's an area where you are selecting. So we are not binding. Again, I would like to say, Even if drone is not mentioned there, it doesn't mean they will not accept drone. So any technology, if you have a technology which is really good into the market, which is not present into the market, you are coming with a solutions. So I think everything is acceptable at this level.
So another question, like as a startup, we might be working on multiple products. Is it okay if we submit multiple proposals?
In a single call, we generally discourage because, see, it's a public funding, proper distribution to all industry must be there. So you will also not get much more opportunity also. It will not happen that if you are putting two proposals, two will come out. So, yeah, you can apply under different countries, I'm saying, at the same time.
Okay.
But under same country, and even one proposal which has been funded in one country will not get again funded under other country. So maybe a different proposal can be.
You have to see
from that perspective. So in a single call, more than one, though our guidelines does not say anything, but we don't encourage. In that case also, whichever is the best may get awarded.
Yes, that would be good, yes. Because these are high-risk projects, and it's better to have multiple. And then choose one.
Yes.
Thank you.
Hi, Rahul. Hello.
Yes.
Hi, Rahul. So, Kshitij here. Just wanted to know if under this collaboration, if out of two companies, if one company is not like contributing much to the project, let's say it's a kind of a bias thing where one company is providing 20% of the support for the whole project. So what is the criteria for this funding? Should it be balanced between two companies, or what is the exact criteria GITA is looking for?
Okay, it's a good question in terms of, I just make you understand, see, both governments are funding this project. So both sides will also see that whatever country is getting. So in terms of, it should not happen. So generally, we are looking for a complementary strength. We are looking for a role and responsibility of the projects in terms of, in terms of project balance, we ideally want 50-50%, maybe 60-40%, maybe 70-30%, but it should not be less than that. So not too much imbalance into the project does not give confidence, because it looks like a customer-vendor relationship only. It's not a co-development. Even that, because evaluation happened for both companies, Indian company and also the counterpart company. So in that case, the evaluation, if the evaluation fails on any one of the sides, the project will not get funded. So that you have to ensure that the collaboration is coming in a balanced way. That is what I mean.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you.
Hello, Rahul. Devyanshu here.
Yes.
Sir, is there any project available in Jharkhand, India?
No, we had not funded any project in Jharkhand. We wanted to fund. I should tell you, very rarely we get proposals from this area. Most of the attraction I've seen is coming from the southern part of the country, mostly like Karnataka, Tamil Nadu. These are the areas where I get proposals. Then like Maharashtra in Mumbai, and then the Delhi definitely. So we wanted to spread this funding not only in all part of India, also in the Northeast India also. So everybody should be able to take this opportunity. But yes, it is based on quality of proposals. So if the proposals are really quality and it's coming out with all competitive proposals, so it can be funded. So there is no such thing that we were. But yes, we wanted to fund in different states. That is our aim, that we can spread. Recently, we funded in MP. We had never funded in MP because no company has come from that part of it. People think, actually speaking, from outside, it looks to be a very critical, complex process. However, once you enter, you will understand it's a very helpful process to you. In matchmaking, we help. You also get your matchmaking partners, both the government helping you for B2B. So that is how you get. Hand-holding is done by GITA. We have a team. We will be, anytime you have any difficulties, even in application form, understanding how the collaboration should go ahead, what are the points should be taken care of when you go for international collaboration. So all those things, we guide people time to time, industries we guide actually. So that will help industry to because sometimes it happens, especially in India, we are very good in technical, but presenting all those things is not very good, especially MSMEs and startups also. Many times we are not able to present properly in terms of impact of the project, potential into the market, demand, what novelty it is coming, though they are doing a very good niche job. But in terms of presenting the information and putting the information does not come out. So we help them in terms of making them understand what informations are required at this stage.
So if I want to do agriculture, if I want to do for agriculture purpose, then what permissions are required for it? And what type of drone?
No, so see, there is one regulation that you have to follow. So that is under DGCA or maybe from the, what I understand, I said for ATC, you have
Rahul,
to take.
That's a question that we can take on another forum. This is more to do with the funding and the R&D process. So any questions related to the presentation, please go ahead. We have, I think, last 5 minutes.
Hi, Rahul.
Sir,
hi. Just need clarification on two scenarios. Imagine one of the government entity, in case of Ministry of Civil Aviation, wants to collaborate with another country, which is not listed in these 8 countries, on, let's say, European or an American, on civil aviation counter-drone detect and avoid technologies, or any such new technologies which are related to integration of drones in the civil aviation airspace. What are the modalities of incorporating these new entities, and what are the modalities of government versus a private company or a Indian company with the foreign government entities, civil aviation entities?
Okay, so right now, if you are saying a government going to a private entities or a private entity is going to a government entity, it's an open forum. It's in terms of modality. One is, like you are saying, it is amongst this country, it is not there. Then the civil aviation, like Ministry of Commerce, they come forward to us. They said, okay, you have a program with Korea and DST funded, but we wanted to get engaged with you, because we are interested in Korea. We wanted to have some of the areas where we want the Indian industry should get benefit, or the Indian ministry should get benefit. So this is how the civil aviation ministry, they can come to GITA, they can engage GITA, and similarly, we can talk with the international government first, have a G2G kind of MOU with civil aviation ministry and those international government which are not available in our portfolio. If it is already available, you can just add up and you said, okay, this is the funding available, civil aviation will provide funding from this side to maybe to the private industry or the public entity also, and from that side they will also add some areas of focus. So that can be done. But a new country you are proposing, then we have to start from the scratch. Means civil aviation ministries having a kind of MOU with those country ministry who are dealing with innovation, mostly in science and technology ministry or the innovation agency, and then it comes to us, and under that platform it can be funded. Any kind of technology collaborations can be funded under that.
Thank you.
Hi, Rahul. Likhin here. I was just wondering, I was just going through the GITA website. We do have a drone startup in Bangalore. We were trying to look at the programs that have already been funded, like the success stories that you had mentioned, right? But they're not exactly mentioned on the website in itself. How can we, I mean, just to know that we are not repeating while we are putting our proposal forward.
Okay, we have a booklet, not only for the success story, it's an overall funded project or approved project of GITA. I'm not sure whether we uploaded, because recently it has come out. Every year we update it. Most probably what I will do, I may give the link to Smith or Deep, who are in connect with me, and they can circulate to all these people. Then you can see all the projects which are funded. We don't give too much, but from overall you will understand, okay, this is the project that has been funded under GITA.
Yeah,
all the listed project must be there.
Yeah, I think that is what
Up to November 2020, because generally we have our foundation day every year in November, and every year all the projects which get completed, they are awarded by the ministers and all those things at our level. So that time we released this booklet also. So up to last year, 2020, all the projects must be there. After that, we have not added much. Only one is this counter drone system, which I just mentioned recently, especially in drone area. So that is what.
Right. So it will be really helpful for us because, I mean, we are incubated at IIIT Bangalore. So even we as a cohort do not know much about GITA and also the proposals that are available. So yeah, it will be helpful for us.
Sure. So most of the time, even you should keep on, I mean, you just follow us on our LinkedIn group also. Any projects which are funded, we generally declare the results also there. However, I will share the booklet, which are the projects funded or approved under GITA. So I'm not saying that same kind of project will never be funded. So what is the difference that we always see? It may happen the earlier project may not be that much affordable. You are coming with a better affordable solution.
Exactly.
That can also be funded. Yeah. That's not a much challenge for us. Maybe with the different countries also, that is not a much challenge. We have funded, even in defense, under Technology Development Board, Technology Development Fund. This is how we see the approach. If 10 companies come out with a solution and 5 companies have cleared the technical. So how we select? We select one or two companies for each project based on the complexity or the different approach for the solution. So that is what we see. If it is the same approach, same solution, then definitely we are not interested to have a repeated. But if it is different approach, so or a lesser cost, that is what means when government funding comes, mostly it's a technical, national importance, indigenization, social importance, affordability. Those are the areas we are looking for.
Yeah, thank you, Rahul. I think that's exactly why I asked for the list, so that we have an advantage, and only one application should be enough and no more clarifications from our side when we apply.
Sure.
Yeah, thank you.
Okay, last round of questions. In case there are any more questions, please feel free to unmute yourself and ask the question. I think that's the end of the session. Thanks, Rahul, for this wonderful presentation. I hope many of our industry members are going to make some very interesting proposals and submit it soon. And from Drone Federation of India side, any expertise that you may require or any help that you may require from a domain perspective, we'll be happy to support that to GITA. For all the other details, everyone, please do note, we will send out an email with the brochure that Rahul was talking about and a few other details. And in case there are any further questions, you may look at the details in the email and reach out to Rahul directly. Thank you so much for joining in. I hope this was a wonderful session and we'll keep doing many more such sessions. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Smith and Deep, Rahat, who has really coordinated for this session. Thank you for this opportunity. If anybody have any questions apart from this, in terms of understanding, getting the partners, because some programs are on just now, many we will be floating in the end of this year. So you keep on watching our websites, and you can keep on approaching us if you need any partner search, or you already have a partner, so you can come to us for any kind of guidance. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you, Rahul. Goodbye.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thank you, Rahul.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.